Hi, everyone. I'm Drop, and this is Plop.
Hello.
We are here to teach you about the wonderful world of water and other things too. This time we are looking at the tail of the tap, where we get our water. If you turn on the taps in your kitchen or bathroom, you will find fresh, clean, running water, safe to drink or brush your teeth with.
Woohoo! Look at all that water!
It's not good to waste water, Plop.
Why? There's loads of the stuff.
A lot goes into cleaning water and getting it into your home, so it's important to not waste it. Come with me and I'll show you what I mean.
OK.
Over 70% of Wessex Water's drinking water comes from underground sources called boreholes. Rainwater soaks into the ground through porous rocks and collects in aquifers. This water can then be pumped to the surface where it is cleaned and checked. The remaining 30% comes from springs and reservoirs, like this one in Somerset. The reservoir collects all this rain and stores it ready for when it's needed.
But this water has fish in it. That doesn't seem very clean.
It's cleaned at the water treatment centre before being stored in a service reservoir and pumped into people's homes.
Or they could add potatoes and people would get yummy fish and chips out of their taps.
Let me show you how they clean the water.
Can we get fish and chips on the way?
This is a water treatment centre.
Wow, it's big.
Well, it treats millions of litres of water every day, so it has to be big. Inside, there are filters, chemicals and screens that remove dirt, bugs and harmful bacteria. It all starts at the inlet chamber. At this stage, the water is very dirty, but it's just the beginning of the journey. It's continuously monitored to check how dirty it is. Screens remove solids such as sticks, stones, and fish. This is where the chemicals are added. Chemicals are used to help the dirty water coagulate.
What does coagulate mean?
Coagulate means the water gets thicker and stickier. This makes it easier to remove the dirt at the next stage. This is the flocculation chamber.
Echo, 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 echo.
Yes, thank you, Plop. In these tanks beneath our feet, the coagulated water is slowly mixed, causing the dirt to stick together and form clumps. This water then flows into the dissolved air flotation tank.
That's a daft name.
Actually, you're right, it is. DAFT stands for Dissolved Air Flotation Tank. In this tank, clean water is mixed in, producing tiny bubbles that float the clumps of dirt up to the surface where they are scraped off, leaving the cleaner water underneath.
Great! I could use a drink. All this has made me really thirsty.
Hang on, Plop. The water is not quite ready to drink. At this stage, the water is crystal clear, but it still smells and would taste horrible.
Smells okay to me.
You might not be the best judge on that one, Plop. The water passes down through layers of sand and granulated carbon, which is very small but has lots of tiny holes in it. These holes trap pesticides and any bad tastes and smells. Chlorine and lime are added to kill off any bacteria left behind, and the water is ready to be pumped into homes. And there you have it, fresh and clean water, right to your taps. So, what's it like?
Ah, really great.
So now you know what it takes to get the water to your tap, will you try and save water when you can?
Yes, yes I will. Although right now, I think I need to make water.
What do you mean?
I've drunk so much, now I really need the loo.
Hey! This might seem like an odd question, but what happens to the stuff you flush down the loo?